Hey guys, what's up? My name is Moshe, and this video is part of my Salesforce Admin Tool series. Hope you will find this necessary. If you are working in a multilingual company and your company is using Salesforce platform, then you are probably familiar with this following scenario. You have lots of custom labels, picklist values, tabs, and more you need to translate in order them to work as expected in different languages. In order to do so, you have two solutions. The first solution is manual translations, which allows you to translate each component for different languages. In Salesforce, you can translate everything. You just need to find the correct place to do it. You can use the translation workbench to translate picklist values, field labels, buttons, and more. You need to use the rename tabs and labels menu to translate all your tabs. And if you want to translate your custom labels, so you should go to the custom labels area to translate all your custom labels. Oh, so much to do here. Or you can just use Sdf files, which is a shortened for Salesforce translation files. Salesforce let you the opportunity to easily export a file and import it back with all the translations on it. So, how we'll be doing this? This is all the steps we need in order for us to use Salesforce STF files. So, first, we'll export the STF files from the translation workbench. We'll find our file in the Documents tab. From there, we will take them and open them in Excel. We'll translate them. We'll save the file in UTF-8 format. We'll use Notepad in order to do so. And in the end, we'll import the file we just saved back to Salesforce with all the translations on it. In the following example, we are going to translate a few custom labels from English to Spanish. First, we'll be going to the setup and look for export underneath the translation workbench. In this screen, we will choose the bilingual file type and export it as STF file. We will find our file in the Documents tab with the name bilingual and the date of today. So we'll click on it and click on View File. This will download our file. We'll open the file and move it from the zip file to our desktop that it will be easier to use it. Our next step is going to be to open the file in Excel and to start translate. So, we'll open a new Excel sheet. We'll be going to the Data tab and choose the From Text option. The next step is going to be to open our file and to start translate all the labels inside of it. If you can't find your file, change to all files. And now you'll see the file here. Just let me double check that this is our file. Just before we start, we just need to set these options. We'll choose the delimiter to be tab because we want the labels to be separated with tabs. And we'll choose origin as UTF-8. And for the first time, this is our STF file. This is how it looks like. As you can see, there are a lot of rows with all the labels that existed in your org. The file itself is separated to two main zones, translated and untranslated, which actually means if the label already has a translation or don't. At the top of our STF file, you can see the header. STF file must contain the translated language code, otherwise Salesforce won't know which language you are translating to. This is something really important to notice if you have lots of languages in your org. And now come the fun part. We'll be translating all our desired translations inside the Excel file. And this is how we're going to do it. We'll delete the translation that already exists in our org, and we'll replace it with an already copied values. We'll be also replacing the asterisk with a hyphen, which means this label is not out of date. And we'll be saving the file in a Unicode format. We'll save it on the desktop, that it will be easier to find. We'll give it a name. And we'll click Save. So now we have a translated file. The only thing left is to convert the file to be an STF file that Salesforce can import. We'll be using Notepad in order to convert the file from Unicode to STF. We will save the file. We'll change the format of the file to be UTF-8 instead of Unicode, and we'll give the file the end of STF. We'll click Save, and just for the end, we'll remove the text ending, so the file will be STF file. As you can see, the file is changed, and now it's ready to be uploaded back to Salesforce. We'll be going to the translation workbench again, but instead of export, we'll write import. In the import screen, we'll click on the choose file button, and we'll choose the STF file we just made. And now the magic happens. Before I'll be clicking the import button, I just want to open the custom label so you can see the transition in the translation. I'll be opening the custom label that we have previously created. As you can see, the translation text is a question mark. So now I'm clicking on the import button. We'll get that message that tells us that the import was successful. And now we'll refresh the page. As you can see, the translation text has changed. Yay! So basically, this is it. We have finished our cycle. Maybe there are just few things you need to know. Sometimes this process got stuck from various reasons. In order to troubleshoot these problems, you need to go to the document tab and find the file you just imported. Click on the view file to see the log what happened to the file. Normally, the problems that you will encounter are a mismatch in the custom label's name, or maybe a picklist value that is not really existing in the org. But if none of them happen, then your import process should succeed. So guys, this is it. This is how you can use Salesforce to help you translate your entire org easily and in one place. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, I'll be glad to help. It can be really frustrating sometimes, I know, but it works. You can reach me here on YouTube or to find me in my LinkedIn profile below. Thanks for watching. See you next time.